Hi, everyone. I'm Frank Malicote. I'm an anchor reporter for KTVU Fox 2 here in the San Francisco Bay Area. My guest is the co-founder of Kabbage. That's Kabbage with a K, by the way. They are the third largest lender of the Paycheck Protection Program loans to small businesses during the COVID situation. Let's say hi to Catherine Petralia. Catherine, how are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks so much for having me.
Good to have you with us as well. Tell us about Kabbage just right out of the gate, what you folks do.
Well, pre-COVID, Kabbage was an automated cash flow management platform for small businesses. Started out providing working capital, lines of credit to small businesses, and deployed over $10 billion to 150,000 small businesses over the last 10 years. And we've always been a fully automated technology platform, so customers could come to the site and go from landing on the site to funds in their account in less than 10 minutes. So we took that same platform and basically converted it to a PPP machine for the last few months.
I guess so. And are you busy?
We're incredibly busy. I was late getting on this Zoom call because I was talking to a customer on the phone.
Oh, very good. Very good. Well, I understand there's about $140 billion still to be divvied up in the coffers for the PPP loans. That kind of surprises me. How about you?
You know, it surprises me. It surprised me weeks ago when we saw that the number wasn't declining. In fact, some days there was more money than there had been the day before because folks were returning their loans for a variety of reasons. And I think a lot of it is around lack of education. People don't necessarily know that it's for them, that they could apply for it, especially when it comes to independent contractors and sole proprietors. And I think there's a lot of fear and uncertainty about will it be forgiven and what are the terms and how's that going to work out? And they don't want to be stuck with debt.
So if I'm a small business out there, I need help, I come to Kabbage. Take me through the process.
So what you need to do is have all of the documents that are required for the PPP loan, which are tax documents. If you have employees, then it's your W-3, proof of your, you know, your organizational documents and identity information. And then if you're an independent contractor or a sole proprietor, then your 1040C and your identification is what we need for that. You upload the documents. Our system automatically classifies the documents, extracts the data, performs the calculation, and submits the application to the SBA. So you can get through the whole process in a few hours, actually, if you have all the right documents when you come to our site.
Well, I know some people that are still kind of climbing through red tape. How quickly do you get a loan if you can get that all in? And I know a deadline's approaching as well.
If you have the right documents and you upload them and our system can read them, which we can in about 75 to 80% of the cases, then you'll have the money the next day. If you get to us, yeah, if you get to us, you know, before 6 p.m.
And that's June 30th, right? But the 28th for you folks.
Yeah, the program ends June 30th, but we end at 11:59 p.m. on the 28th because sometimes it can take time to get to the SBA and to get a response and disperse the funds. So we don't want to put people in a bad position who are applying those last 2 days. And the SBA hasn't yet told us exactly when they're going to turn off their system either. So if we had that information, it would be helpful.
Do you have any insider information from the Capitol? Will this get extended or do you think it's a done deal at the end of the month?
I really hope that they extend it. Originally, they had extended it through the end of the year, but then there was some debate about was it December 31st or not. And so I think with this much capital left, it is incumbent upon the folks who created this program in the first place to extend it because we can see our volume has been nuts the last few days as we've approached the end. I don't think there's any downside to extending it. I also think as we're seeing more cases around the country and potentially shutdowns are going to continue, then I think there may be a need for an additional program or to let folks come back for another few weeks of payroll just to help, you know, tide them over.
Yeah, especially with it, what looks like a, you know, COVID's not going anywhere anytime soon. What are the requirements? If you are a company, this money has to go to certain things, right? You can't just get it and grow, so to speak.
That's correct. So you do have to have prepared tax documents. If you're an independent contractor or a sole prop, you don't have to have filed your taxes because that deadline has been extended to July 15th. But you do have to have prepared documents for 2019. And you need to have identification, a government-issued ID. That's for independent contractors and sole proprietors. And then for folks who have employees, we would need, you know, something like a 940 and a W-3 to demonstrate payroll. So the whole idea is to use documentation that is proof of payroll or income that has been taxed.
And you mentioned it earlier, but you folks have been busy. I don't know if these numbers are up to date, but over 110,000 loans, $3.5 billion. Does that sound about right?
Hold on. I'm going to sneak away from you for 1 second and look at my most updated numbers. We have a little dashboard here. So the number, the approvals right now are, of course, now it's 180,000 applications approved, which puts us in third place now behind, I believe, Bank of America and Chase. And we've SBA has approved $5.12 billion.
Wow. So if you're a small business out there and for whatever reason you haven't done it, or perhaps you ran into some roadblocks, knocking on your door might be a good idea, right? And the next
day. That is a good idea. Absolutely. But do it before Sunday at 11:59 p.m.
Wow. Okay. Well, I always ask the folks I'm interviewing about where they live. You're in Atlanta. Tell us, I know that's been a bit of a hot spot. What's it like there right now in terms of COVID-19?
It's interesting. In Atlanta proper, and I live in town, it hasn't actually been as intense as it has been in certain parts of the state itself. So in some of the more rural areas, we've had some real significant hotspots in the northwest of the state and in the southeast, northeast and southwest. But I think in Atlanta, we're starting to see the cases rise. You know, we have the CDC right here in our backyard. And so I think there's a lot of information and a lot of caution being taken by people in Atlanta because of the knowledge and the infiltration of the CDC. But yesterday, I believe there were 111 fatalities due to COVID in Fulton County. So we're definitely seeing a rise. And they don't know why. They think it could be because of recent protests that have happened and a lot of people in proximity to one another. And it could be just because people got together for the holidays. And now, you know, more transmission is beginning to happen.
And you yourself tested and you got antibodies, so you likely had the virus sometime this past year, I guess, right?
I'm pretty sure I had it in March, and I think I know where I got it, but I was really fortunate. I was barely sick at all, and I had to take two tests because my husband didn't believe that he could possibly be negative if I was positive, so I did it twice.
Really? And did you feel any kind? Was it just like a common cold or a flu? You said
it wasn't even that bad. I just had a little cough, which I thought might have been allergies, which I don't normally have. But Atlanta's full of pollen in the spring, so I was very, very lucky.
And how about your family? Did they have to quarantine after they found that out, or I guess
we didn't know. I never knew. There were no tests. So I called my sister the day that I had this weird little cough. She works for the CDC. And I said, hey, where can I go get tested? She's like, there's nowhere to go get tested. You're just going to have to, you know, if you're worried that you have it, then you should self-quarantine. But we really didn't think that was possible.
So if folks want to get a hold of Cabbage, what do they do?
Cabbage.com with a K. K-A-B-B-A-G-E.com.
Nice and easy. Cabbage with a K. Catherine Petralia, you are the co-founder of Cabbage, and want to thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
And I'd like to backdrop as well, right up to speed with the coronavirus. We appreciate that.
Thank you.
I'm Frank Malika with KTVU Fox 2 here in the Bay Area. For more information, go to coronavirusnow.com. Have a great day, everybody.